What a great montage that is, and that's what we had yesterday, and I'm sure we're going to have the same sort of excitement today, except yesterday was freestyle, today's Heelwork to music. We'll go into that in a little bit more detail once we get the competition underway. Now, we've got the judges' tables there. You'll notice the judges' tables have been separated, so we don't allow them to talk. So they can't confer on opinions. We get three judges' opinions. It's a bit like the ice dancing and the other type of programmes, isn't it? Except we separate our judges. And, of course, we have three tables. We need three judges. Would you like to welcome the judges into the arena, please? Firstly, we've got Anne D'Arizio. Oh, looking very smart today, Anne. Secondly, it's our head judge, Gina Pink. If there is a tie in the mark, we need a head judge to sort that out. And thirdly, we've got our visiting judge from Switzerland, it's Claudia Moser. We'll just wait for the judges to get themselves seated and comfortable and sharpen their pencils. There is a delay after each routine. As you know, what we have to do is wait for the judges to actually sort out their marking. And all the way through, we'll think, well, we like this, we prefer that. That's not the way it works, because they have a list of technical things they have to fulfill in the routine. They'll be looking at the individual moves that make up a routine. Lots of things where we're looking at, well, I called it the X Factor yesterday, and that's the entertainment value. But you'll get the idea as we go along now, and we'll see if our judges are all ready to go. Get themselves comfy. You get yourself comfy, Gina. Get the chair right. You all right now? Right, I think we're ready for our first competitor. Now, Heelwork to music it is, not freestyle, so two-thirds of it should be roughly based on Heelwork, but I'll explain to you in detail later. So, running order number one, we've got Annette Lowe with her dog, Balliol. And the Kennel Club registered name of the dog is Kinaway Mystic Spires. It's a border collie, a three-year-old border collie, so still rather on the young side. And they're just wanting to advance classes in both Heelwork and freestyle within 3 months of starting to compete in each discipline. So must be fairly talented, and we hope we've got a good start here. Loves his family and working, and he's a delight to live with. Now they're performing to a track by Boney M, and it's called Rasputin. So I think we're on the music maestro, please. Well done, Annette. That was a very nice routine performed there with a very popular piece of music. And probably a good place. Now, while the judges are doing their thinking time and writing the marks down, I'll just explain a little bit about what we're seeing. When the sport started in 1990, it was started when Mary Ray was asked by a guy called John Gilbert in Luton at an evening she was doing, if she'd put some, he was going to play some music, would she pick a track and do some heel work to music? And what she did, they played a track, I think it was Eye of the Tiger, she had two dogs there, and one of them was Eye of the Tiger, and she did heel work, competition heel work to music. And the audience, there was about 100 in the audience, they went away and said, let's see in heel work to music. And she did it again and then thought, I'd better put this to the music and choreography, put a bit of choreography into it. And that's what she did, is choreograph the music to the moves of the dog. And then from there, all the moves came in. And we had a freestyle section later in the 90s. In fact, the first competition was in 96, but we had star moves come in, which is all the tricks that we see with the dogs do, whether it be on TV and other competitions as well. So we split it then, and it went into two divisions. One's called Heelwork to Music, and one's called Freestyle. With Freestyle, you can do any of the tricks to music you want, and that's what they are. We call them moves. They are actually well-trained tricks. And in Heelwork to Music, two-thirds of it has to be based on heelwork, which is why predominantly what you're going to see this morning is heelwork. It can be at the front, side, back, other side, anywhere, but two-thirds of it should be based on heelwork. And obviously the other third, then you can get the other freestyle moves where the dog's rolling over or doing things at a distance. But that's what you just see. Now I'll continue this conversation after the next dog. But let's see how she did. This is Annette Lowe. Let's see what her scores are. First dog in. Oh, they're just coming up on screen now. Oh, she's got a 7.5, an 8.2 and a 7. 22.7. Oh, we're down a little bit there. We've got a 6.5. On accuracy, the other score, 6.9. 7, 6.3 and 22. I hope we're sure these are correct. We had a little bit of a problem with the scores yesterday. 7, 8, 7, 2, 22, 9. Nothing to do, 21.93. That's a really good score. Give it a nice round of applause. Well done. Right, next handler is on the line, ready to go. The judges are pens poised, and it's Lucy Heath with her dog. Still more wind to sun. It's a border collie. Unfortunately, I don't know the dog's pet name. It hasn't been put down. The dog's 6 years old. It's a bitch. And it's a second appearance here in the Heelwork to Music finals. And she's performing to a track by Jamie Berry, and it's called Delight. Give her a round of applause. Lucy Heath performing Judy Light. What a great upbeat routine. Great punchy piece of music. And what, a couple of moves in there I haven't seen before, the hopping about, but certainly the dog was enjoying it. Again, you could give it our marks for what we think it looked like, but the judges will be looking at the accuracy of the move Shashi did. Heelwork to music, if you compare it with dancing, of course, we're talking, this will be ballroom dancing where freestyle will probably be jiving. That's the difference in it. So it's very difficult to actually train a dog to work so close to you and keep it consistent and do everything. And most of them do most of their commands by signal rather than voice. And as you can imagine, you couldn't force a dog to do things like this, whether it be doing the tricks away or close heel work. You can only get them to do it if they want to do it. And virtually everyone in heel work to music actually trains, does clicker training, which is a very kind method of training because you're actually using food. Some people don't use a clicker, they use voice command at the same time, but it's all food and treat related. So the dogs actually love doing it. And that's the best way to way forward with training dogs in everything we know. The old days of pulling, we called it the grab and pull brigade from 30 or 40 years ago, the old fashioned training methods, they really have gone now. Modern training methods dictate that you use a lot of treats and don't give up on the treats ever in the long term, because some people think, well, the dog knows how to do it, I won't treat it anymore. But you know, I mean, in the long term, you may be a bit more sparing with the treats. But dogs are like humans, you know. If you want them to work and do a job, we wouldn't do it for nothing, and we shouldn't expect dogs to do it. They need payment. Their payment's a bit of food. And if you give them payment on a regular basis, you'll get a result because they work hard for you, because they want to. Now, I think we're ready with the result for Lucy. We know she's got to beat 21.83 to take the lead. Here we go. Still more winners on Lucy Heath, and he's looking good already. 8.683 and 8, 24.9. Oh, there's that little six is in there again, 7.1 there. And another six, 20.4, so this could be close. Interpretation, that was good, the interpretation. 23.5, what's the total? Oh, deductions. There was some barking I heard there. And there are deductions for barking, and that is what's going to sink the ship for her, I think. 4.6 off, the barking was really bad. 21.4, otherwise she would have taken the lead there, but there is, all the judges can deduct points. It normally would only ever be used for handling the dog, to push it into when it made a mistake, giving it a shove over, which is very rare, mainly used for barking. The dog shouldn't be barking. The more barking, the more faults, and there was quite a bit of barking in there. Right, next handler coming in now, running order number 3, and the dog's handled by Leslie Neville with Dewey. A bearded collie, as you can see. Rambledale Blue Dewey is his full name. 3 years old, and this will be Dewey's first time here on the green carpet at Crufts. He's still a baby at 3 years and 3 weeks old, which is what he will be today, 3 years and 3 weeks old. Anyway, they're also performing to a Boney M tune, and it's called Rasputin. I think we've already had this one. Anyway, Leslie, over to you.
and his hunger for power became known to more and more people, the demands to do something about this outrageous man became louder and louder.
Great routine, lovely looking dog as well. Well done, Leslie. We normally expect to see a lot of props in the arena with the routines going on. Sometimes we have some props for Heelwork music, but the props are mainly in the freestyle section. And tomorrow, don't forget, tomorrow we have got the international freestyle, and we've got 15 countries competing tomorrow. That really, really will be a must to see. If you can't make it here and watch it live in the arena, you really want to be on the live feed via the Crufts website, and you can watch everything all day long that is in this arena. So you really would be a good thing to watch tomorrow, the international freestyle. Really a great competition, and it just highlights how many countries, just like agility, you know, we invented agility at Crufts in 1978. It was invented at that show with a demonstration, turned into a competition. By early 1980, it was already spreading through Europe, and now it's all over the world, and it is exactly the same with Heelwork to Music. Just after it was started in 1990, the first demonstration, it then popped up in America, in Canada first, and then throughout the world. So now we even have a world championship for Heelwork to Music, or freestyle as well, I should say. So we've got the international freestyle tomorrow. You want to be on the live feed tomorrow if you can't be here in person. Right, here we go. Leslie Neville's results. Stunning dog and a really nice routine. 7.182 and 6.4 for content, 21.7. Accuracy, 7. There's two sixes there, 19.5. The judges weren't too sure about the accuracy of them. We've got an 8 there, 7.5, 7.3, 22.8. Will it take the lead? Nothing to take off, 21.33. No, it won't. It goes into third place. So we're ready for our next handler. This is running order number 4. The dog's name Charlie, and the handler's called Jackie Roberts. So give it a nice big hand into the arena. Rosamac Marmite Soldier is the full Kennel Club registered name of the dog. It's a working sheepdog, 5 years old. And Jackie's first dog ever, the first time competing at Crufts. So you get your first dog ever and then can finish up competing at Crufts. The track is by the Boston Pops Orchestra, and it's called March of the Toys. So, music maestro, please. Thank you. Give him a big round of applause. Great routine. I'm not going to say too much because I don't want to be accused of giving an opinion over the tannoy, because the judges are thinking. When you, I know when, if you take Jackie's routine there, you start this process of getting to Crufts earlier in the year. There are a series of heats. I think you have to come in the top two or win one of the heats to get through to the semi-final. The semi-final was held in January at the Kennel Club building at Stoneleigh, end of January. There were 20 plus finalists there, and that's whittled down to 10, so only the best arrive here at Crufts. Now, in the process through the summer, at the end of the year, all the handlers will be trying to finalise their routines and actually fine-tune them. And it's not just doing the training of the dog. You've got to decide the music in the first place, and that is one of the most difficult things to do. We've seen two people have had the same music. You don't know until you enter the shows, or maybe not until the semi-final, that somebody else is actually using the music you're using. So there's a comparison there. You want to try and have something original, but the trouble is most of the music has already been used by someone somewhere. Very difficult to actually get the right music, and you might want different music for freestyle than you do for Heelwork music. And then, of course, there's the outfit to complement it. You have to be a bit careful. I'll tell you a little story about that in the next break. To make sure that it's the right and appropriate outfit to go with the routine and nothing outlandish. And that's a good example of it we've just seen there with Jackie in a dress and the Toy Soldier routine. Right, score, here we go. Jackie Roberts, 8.3. 8.2. This is content. 7.8. Great content that was. And I personally love the next section as well. 8.78, oh, that's a low one, 6.5. Interpretation of the music, that was brilliant, I thought, but as probably you did. But we're just the audience, don't forget, the judges are looking at other things. That's our leader, 23.33, and well deserved as well. Great routine. And into the lead she'll go with that. Now, our next routine, this is number 5 out of our 10 starters, and this is Julia Foland with John's Girl. That's the name of the dog. It's a 10-year-old working sheepdog, 10 years old, and this is the pair's first time at Crufts as well. Very nice sparkly outfit, and they're performing to a track by Leona Lewis. And it's called Bleeding Love. So it will be music maestro, please, when she's all set up. And every handler gives a little signal to the music man.
I don't care what they say.
great routine. Very well performed there by Julia. And a lovely dog as well. Really well performed to the music, nicely choreographed to the music, and obviously it's a great track to use. So once more, we'll just wait on for the judges now to have a good think about the technicalities they're looking at, which of course I've said before, we're looking at the overall impression. Was it a great routine? Was it entertaining? They're looking at the technicalities. Hence, when we think they should deserve a six, sometimes there's a six in there. If you'd like to know anything about working dogs and about Heelwork to music or working trials or obedience, up in Hall 3 there is the activity area, and all the experts from the different disciplines are in there to talk to you. They'll tell you about the shows they're about, where you can go perhaps to join a club to learn more about it, where you can do the training. They're doing little demonstrations up there as well. So all the experts are in Hall 3 on the activity stand. So do go and have a look at them. And don't forget, if you haven't picked up a catalogue at the foyer, there's if you want to go and get one from the foyer at the front, then in actual fact there's a Yukonuba goodie bag free in that as well. Now we're just waiting for the judges' results to come back for that one, and let's see how she did. She had a good nice outfit on as well. I did say that it's always difficult picking the outfit to go with the music. Something else to watch for this weekend again, if you can't be with us live, the Mary Ray's Best in Show routine, which will be on Sunday evening at 7:45, and that'll be going out live on the streaming as well from the Kennel Club website on their YouTube channel. So I think we've got the results in now, and we're ready to go. This is Julia Folan with John's Girl. Very nice, eloquent routine. 81847, 23.5. That's the area she needs to be. Accuracy, 8279, yes. Fairly accurate, that, 23.3. It's whether she can take the lead with this. 7885. As another 8, 24.5. Any deductions? Have our judges been nice? Oh, no, 0.1. There must have been a little bit of something to deduct there. Perhaps a touch and a 2 there. It's 23.07. Into rank 2. And I'm told, but my expert, the sport experts would next to me, said it may be targeting the dog on the hand, which is not allowed in Heelwork to music. Or it's not in the definition of the sport, but we're not absolutely sure. All we know is we're watching the overall presentation. They are very, very carefully watching the detail, which is what even I'm not watching, not being the expert. Anyway, into the arena comes next with her dog called Devon. It's Michelle Dodson. Oh, Aisha's arrived with Kinaway Dr. Kildare. It's a Border Collie, 6 years old. And this is her fourth appearance at Crufts, the first with Devon and first in the Heelwork division. Having previously achieved second and two third places in freestyle. Devon is 6 years old and also enjoys obedience and flyball. He is an incredible loving dog with a huge heart, and he likes everyone and everything. I think she's all set up now. The music is by the China National Symphony Orchestra, and it is Hero.